Hello, my lovers. Welcome back. I'm Coach Kara, and we're here with another dating and or relationship topic. So we are going to talk about the pros and cons of interracial dating. So yeah, thank you for joining me today. Welcome, welcome, all new and old. So when it comes to interracial dating, it can be a thing for many people. But I want to share with you all some of the cons and pros that come along with that and some adjustments that can be acquired. So when it comes to interracial dating, you have two different cultures. And obviously, and some interracial dating, it could be like one of those cultures to where they are very into what they have a strong belief. You know, it's just say you meet someone from China and you yourself, you're from Abu Dhabi. All right. Two separate cultures, quite similar in some areas, but different. All right. So there's going to be, you know, talks about religion, common practices, beliefs, you know, just one's way of life. Those sorts of things, those sort of discussions will need to be had to see if there's going to be, you know, understanding and being able to, you know, condone it and tolerate it and even practice as well. So being with someone who is from a completely different culture from you, at some point, that person, or maybe even both of you, you're going to want this person to conform in some sort of way. It could be the way you dress or, you know, the way you eat, things that you do as far as hobbies. They may want you to alter that in some way. So that within itself, although it may be helpful, it could be a little challenging to try to convert, you know, conform and adjust to a new way of doing things, a new way of life. All right. So that's that, as far as trying to bring two separate cultures together. Resolving issues. Okay. You may have a culture that believes in, okay, I'm the man of the house. I'm the leader. I make the rules. You're submissive. You abide by this. And that's that. Or there could be, let's go to therapy, but I don't believe in therapy. Your person may just want, you know, the both of you to just go and pray to Allah. Do some fasting, be more spiritual about it. So it's going to be a topic of conversation of conflict resolution. How are you going to resolve your issues? Is it, you know, just a standard talk and we'll talk our way through this and see what happens and we grow out of it and, you know, and that's that, or what? There's going to have to be a definitive way of resolving issues, especially if one or both of you practice a certain religion that is quite strict. So again, there may be a different way of doing things. So yeah, conflict resolution will definitely need to be at the topic, at the top of your conversations. Food. All right. If your person or both of you are just say not from the States, you know, we kind of eat reckless. We eat whatever we want over here. Unless you practice a certain religion to where you have to eat, you know, certain days and certain foods, that sort of thing. So even still with food, the different cultures, you're going to have to find a way to create that sort of balance. I don't eat curry goat. Well, I don't eat fried rice. It's too much starch, you know? So it's going to have to be a discussion about that. Or do you just eat quite normally, or you don't care what it is that you eat? I mean, that would be a plus, wouldn't it? But then that would just make it too easy. No, life isn't usually that simple. So I would suggest, you know, if you're trying to really be with this person, you care about them and you want to make them happy, you want to bring your cultures together, I would suggest, especially if you don't know how to cook, you know, take a cooking class. You may find some fun out of that. Learning different types of ways to cook, you know, easy, quick cuisines. or cooking together. You're teaching each other different dishes to make it fun. Even if you don't eat it, you'll still know how to prepare it for your person. You know what I'm saying? So I'm sure at some point that would be a topic of discussion as well. I've even heard a guy say, a black guy actually, he was dating, I forget what her race, but she wasn't Caucasian, but she was something else. He was like, oh, I just want some soul food. You know, he wasn't a cook. So it's just the desire to have that. So you have to think in the aspect of plan B. You know, can I go down to MLK and grab some soul food, or go to Chinatown and pick up this, or Little Italy, you know, something like that. You know, you have to have a plan B. Just saying. Next, dancing. Dancing is very big in some cultures, you know, Caribbean, Latino, Hispanic. Dancing is big. So if you meet someone, or maybe yourself, who does not dance, or you have no rhythm, you have very poor rhythm, that can be an issue. It really could be. It could be a buzzkill, because if you're dating Mr. Latino over there and he's salsa and he's mamba, and then you look, guys, let me tell you, when it comes to rhythm, it really does matter. My ex, his father was, or is, black and German. And all the German that was in his father, or is in his father, seeped into his bloodstream strong, right? He has no rhythm. He dances like a three-year-old, like. But it's cute. But here's the thing, when it comes to rhythm, specifically in males, that trickles down into the bedroom, okay? Yes, it does. To experience having sex with someone who is out of sync with your body, or the rhythm doesn't flow, it could be a little disappointing. It could be quite disappointing, to say the least, because it's a significant difference, you know, especially from what you've had before, who was, you know, really in sync with your body, or hell, even afterwards, you can tell the difference. So if you don't think that that correlates, my love, from experience, I tell you, it does. So if you're dating a man and he tells you he does not have rhythm, he's not a dancer, you should really think about that, of how important your sex life is to you. If it doesn't matter all that much, you don't have sex all that often, but then think nothing of it, okay? But for someone like me, to where it does, and I take it seriously, you're going to have to excel in other areas. So rhythm, okay? Being a rhythmic individual may matter to many people while you're dating them. So that is another thing that you want to think about, or maybe even discuss. And you may say, well, you can go to dance class. So yeah, you can go to dance class if you have a rhythm. But someone with rhythm, there's very little you can do about that, because either way, they're still going to be offbeat. So it's never going to, you know, play out right. It's never going to look right. Sorry. Another issue that you may run into is those awkward moments and awkward conversations. You know, you go to a movie and there's a slur, or something is referenced racially, or you go out and you may get a certain stare, or a certain topic come up between amongst you and friends. You know, so it's always going to be those rare moments to where you may feel a little uncomfortable. You know, the holiday party, you're there with your partner and you seem to be the only person who is just of that one particular race, or any kind of party. You know, it's just you. And it's like, okay, so I'm the only one here. I'm standing out like a sore thumb. Yeah, there's going to be those moments. And you're going to have to think about that. And just, hell, adjust to it. So what? You're with your boo, you know? And if there are any experiences to where you feel very uncomfortable, it's okay. It's not gonna last. It's just a moment. They should have already been expected, you know. So it's nothing to really feel so insecure about. So, but it's just that. Something you just have to deal with. And then there's, you know, racism. of course, that's to be expected. So again, it's just something that you should talk about in the very early stages of dating, of how that makes you feel, what you guys would do in certain instances, just so you're prepared, okay? Because in this world, my love, you just never know. So it's just best to have had some sort of dialogue about it. We can't ignore it because it exists. It is very, very prevalent, even in this time, yeah? Okay, so let's talk about some of the pros. So the good thing about dating someone from a different race or different cultural background is you get to experience a whole new, I guess, world or different culture, you know, foods, clothing, dances, just certain practices. You can travel to, you know, their homeland. I'll just say they're from, I don't know, Sicily. You get to travel and go to those sorts of places and kind of just, I guess, educate yourself. Yeah, educate yourself on different ways of life and different types of people and how they live and their different lingo and just so many differences you get to explore. And it'll be quite refreshing. You know, you might meet someone from Turkey and they have a total different way of life from, you know, Western civilization. So to be able to explore a new culture, it can be always quite surprising, exciting, and more importantly, educational. Okay, yeah. Next, when you date outside of your race, it has a way of changing your mindset, the way you think. You know, you may have had a certain perspective initially, or, you know, maybe years ago, and as time grew, you know, you began to think differently. So it really begins to alter your mindset and open your heart to newness. Because what we're all really put in on this planet to do is just to simply love. Love whomever. If someone is willing to love you and, you know, set aside all differences, so why not open up your heart chakra and let them in? It really allows you to be vulnerable in a different type of way. You know, you challenge yourself, and that's good. So it's a very bold move to date outside of your race, the norm, okay? And when we do these sorts of changes, we shouldn't do it in a negative manner. You know, we should do it because we want something fresh, something different. You want to explore. Even though you may not be as happy with your race itself, you've had poor experiences with dating and that sort of thing. Well, here's the reality of it. Every race relationship is going to have its challenges. I don't care who it is, and this is why I'm doing this video. So it's not going to be easy. You may have escaped one thing from your race, but going into another, you may run into another challenge, which is just like equally nerve-wracking, right? Yes. Another pro is that you get to show everyone unity, how we can come together, though we're two different people. You know, love is love. Love does not discriminate. So when you see someone out in a different cultural backgrounds, embrace it. You know, I saw a couple when I was going food shopping. They were walking out. And, you know, a Caucasian lady and black guy. And I gave her that look like, oh, girl, you got you a good one. Dark chocolate sweetness. Yes. No, gave a little wink. Yeah. She appreciated that. So we don't want to ever make someone feel like they're making a bad choice because their heart chose to go in a different direction. Okay. We should never make someone feel badly because they want to love another human with just a different background, okay? So we should never do that. It's really a great way of just showing how we can all come together and just simply love each other, regardless of, okay? Well, if you need any further dating advice, all of my information will be linked down below. I'll be glad to help you if you have a more unique situation and you need some further dating coaching. Be sure to reach out to me. I thank all of you for joining me always. That is all for now, my love. Until next time.